everything. Gardening guru Linda Vauter is here. You've got some beautiful plants to show us about planting in our windowsills.
Yeah, I mean, you know, we've all lived in apartments or we have lived in rental homes or anything that we don't have any gardens to garden in. All we have is maybe a bright windowsill, and you can grow practically everything in your windowsill, albeit on a smaller scale than you can in your garden. And I have brought examples today because all of these things have been growing in my windowsill.
Beautiful.
Okay, so let's start with vegetables. Okay, you wouldn't necessarily think of those as a plant that you could grow in your windowsill, but you can. The tip is to look for vegetables or herbs, primarily herbs, that will grow in the shade, because the lower light level is obviously going to be a factor, but you still can grow those things. So look for, this is probably my favorite, I pretty much always have flat leaf Italian parsley either inside or out. It's great. You snip it, it will come back. You do want to feed it periodically. This is cilantro. It also likes growing in the shade. Smell that. All of these are so fragrant, so it's especially fun to have them in your windowsill. This is obviously for your tacos, Mexican food, a little bit of Asian vibe there too. And then you and I were kind of sniffing on these, taking a trip down memory lane from when we were kids. These are both mint. One is peppermint, one is spearmint. You can just snip that off. You can put that on your mint julep.
Well, you know, when I was a kid, we had these grown around our house. My mom planted peppermint, and when we were kids, we thought it was cool to just go, hey, watch!
I'm eating a weed, yeah. and the thing is, sometimes it's better to grow it inside it in a container, because mint, you may have also discovered, can be very invasive, so you want to be careful where you plant it out in the garden. You can also grow bulbs. Flower bulbs. You think about, oh my gosh, you know, you see tulips and hyacinths and things like that growing in people's gardens, but you can also grow them in the windowsill, but you're going to do a little cheat.
Okay.
And here's the cheat. Go to your nursery and buy them after they've already been forced, so they're guaranteed to bloom, and then you can take them, like these hyacinths, put them in a pretty little pot that matches your decor. Look at this.
Oh, like that. Okay, yeah, this turns into that.
This turns into that smell.
Oh, wow.
Isn't that wonderful?
I didn't realize they smelled.
For a dollar. A dollar.
A dollar.
And then another consideration for windowsill gardening is make sure that you put a little coaster or something underneath it, because you want to protect the wood or the metal or whatever. You can also even grow trees in your windowsill.
Like these.
Like these miniature little trees. You follow me on Instagram, and you know I'm crazy for topiary. So I will grow topiary just about anywhere and everywhere, and these tiny little myrtle topiaries are so happy growing in the window.
They're beautiful.
And I grow mine in a north facing window, so it doesn't have to have a lot of sun. And that's the other thing about most house plants and most things that you grow inside, they don't necessarily want a lot of bright sun. What they want is bright light.
Okay.
And so you get them close to a window, and actually they're pretty happy there. That said, practically all plants really want to be outside. So every once in a while, take your little myrtle trees, your little bulbs, or I didn't bring any today, but even cactus grow great inside. You're talking about
how I kill cactus.
How you kill cactus.
I can't even keep cactus alive. I overwater, apparently, because I water every 2 weeks instead of once a month.
Well, the thing is, we think we're taking such good care of them by watering them, but that's how we get into trouble, because we water them too much. So, you know, about once a month is fine. Remember, inside, they're not subject to those drying winds and things like that. So,
well, thank you so much for all of this.
You're
welcome.
Like
she said, take your plants for a walk every now and then. Take them outside. This was great.
They're
we appreciate
our pets,
it.
Aren't they?
Yes. And you can follow Linda Vauter on Instagram or read her blog at LindaVauter.com. She's amazing.